This video was designed to highlight key aspects of the culture of human pluripotent stem cells in mTeSR1. mTeSR1 is a novel, defined, complete medium for maintenance of human embryonic and induced pluripotent stem cells without the use of feeders. This standardized culture method minimizes experimental variability, leading to results that are more reproducible. mTeSR1 was designed at the Y-Cell Research Institute and has a fully published formulation, as detailed in two publications, Nature Biotechnology and Nature Methods. To date, mTeSR1 has been shown to maintain more than 50 independently derived human embryonic and induced pluripotent stem cell lines, and has been referenced in over 80 publications, including Cell, Stem Cell, and Nature. Routine culture of human embryonic and induced pluripotent stem cells presents some unique challenges when compared to the culture of other adherent cells. Colony morphology is usually used to monitor the health of human embryonic and induced pluripotent stem cell cultures. For this reason, cultures should be examined daily, using a microscope, to monitor the quality of the cells and to check whether they are ready to be passaged. Cells cultured in mTeSR1 on matrigel-coated plates have a slightly different morphology when compared to those cultured on mouse embryonic fibroblasts, and are more similar to those cultured in conditioned medium. We now examine the morphology of cells during the course of one passage. When viewed under low magnification and phase contrast, we see a few colonies forming within the first 24 hours after seeding. In the following 2 days, the colonies become larger in size, but are still sparsely packed with cells. At days 4 to 7, the density and robustness of the colonies increases rapidly, and you'll see significant changes in their morphology immediately before they're ready for passaging. Cells grown in mTeSR1 are ready to passage when they are large and have centers that are dense and phase bright when compared to their outer edges. If plated at a good density, the borders of the growth areas may be merging. Once all these characteristic traits are displayed, you have a 24-hour window to passage the cells. Some spontaneous differentiation in the culture is expected. It indicates that the cells are healthy and still able to differentiate. Areas of differentiation are characterized by the presence of morphologically different cell types within or at the edge of the colony. Good quality cultures plated at the appropriate density and passaged correctly should display only a few areas of differentiation. You may scrape away these areas before passaging the cells. Now let's walk through the steps to passage human embryonic and induced pluripotent stem cells. We recommend using a two-step method that breaks up the colonies enzymatically and mechanically. Dispase at a concentration of 1 mg per mil is preferable to proteases such as trypsin because it's gentler on the cells. Appropriate treatment with dispase should result in multicellular clumps rather than single cells. Please note that mTeSR1 medium was designed for the passage of cells as clumps. First, wash each well once with DMM F12. Then add dispase to the wells and incubate them at 37 degrees Celsius until the colony edges are slightly folded back but are still attached to the plate. This will usually take 4 to 7 minutes. The culture should be monitored under a microscope to ensure the correct incubation time. If the colonies become detached from the plate, they've been treated for too long. Cells exposed to dispase for too long will likely have difficulty adhering to a new culture plate. Therefore, the timing of the dispase incubation step is crucial. Remove the dispase and gently rinse each well with DMM F12 to stop the dissociation process. It will take a few washes to ensure that all traces of dispase are removed. 3 or more washes are recommended. Once again, if the enzyme is not thoroughly rinsed from the cells, there may be difficulty with adhesion when plating the cells in a new dish. Next, add mTeSR1 and scrape the cells off with a pipette tip. This process will mechanically break up the colonies into smaller clumps. Do this by drawing up the medium, then slowly releasing it back into the well while scraping off the adherent cells. If you have trouble seeing the colonies, tilt the plate slightly. During this step, take care not to allow bubbles to form, since they can be harmful to the cells. When the cells are detached from the well, transfer the medium to a conical tube. Rinse the well with additional mTeSR1 to collect remaining cell clumps, and add the rinse to the tube. Flick the tube lightly, or pipette up and down once or twice using a micropipetter to gently break up the larger aggregates, thus creating a relatively uniform clump suspension. Take care not to reduce the clumps to single cells. After swirling the tube, if clumps hang in suspension rather than sinking quickly, they're the appropriate size and ready to be plated for the next passage. For more information about mTeSR 1 or passaging human pluripotent stem cells, please email us at mTeSR1@stemcell.com or visit our website.